All right, so you went out this morning, little blowout down the lane. Just walk us through it.
Well, to be honest with you, I didn't see much of it because we were stuck here. We had a little shoe, we had a little hind shoe issue with him. We had to get, he had a couple of loose nails, so to make sure he didn't go out there and lose it and break his hoof all up, we had to get the license in to repair it. And by that time, it was a little bit past 8:30. I didn't have a chance to go around to the front. So I just watched, went over by the other gap and just watched him gallop out. So he wasn't supposed to be much of anything anyway, just a 20, you know, I guess 12 and change each eighth and then gallop out a little bit, that's all. I'm really, it looked like it was about right from the way he was galloping out, I would say it was about that. But if it was a little faster or a little slower, it really didn't matter. Well, he got a little something.
What did the rider say coming back?
He said he felt great. He said, you know, he was getting over it nice. He said he got right into the bit. And it looked like he was still into the, you know, it looked like he wasn't pulling up too easy. It looked like he was in the bit nice on the way out around the turn. So I think we're in good shape.
A couple people said it looked like he took a bad step, but I guess you couldn't probably see from where you were. Did he say anything?
I don't know. No. He didn't say anything.
So he came back fine.
Yeah.
Can you talk about the position last night, getting the 20? Does it matter?
I wasn't crazy about it, but he, I looked at a few of the other ones, the other races where the horses that did good drew from outside there. One 2 years ago especially, I couldn't believe how Dream Trip he got from post 19. It was incredible. He was able to draft him behind the horses, and he was where he wanted to be well before he got into the first turn, so it can happen.
Do you know what Calvin's going to do? He's going stage left.
Yeah, he's making a left-hand turn. Yeah.
Do you do anything different because of the slot that you draw? Or?
There's anything. What, you mean training-wise, right? Yeah. No, like to sharpen him to come out of there? No, not really.
Because give a view of what's going on real quick.
Yeah, you know, because at least he won't have anybody on the outside banging him in there. So at least he's got, you know, at least he's got a clear path to where he can, if he feels he has to goose him a little bit more, leave in there if he can without, shouldn't have to, wouldn't have anybody crossing over in front of him anyway.
Well, and with his running style too, I mean, you'll be in a better, you're not as concerned as if you had a up front speed type of horse from that spot, right? He can kind of just draft.
Well, unless you're just absolutely the best speed like Big Brown was that year. I mean, he stayed out there and just cleared everybody and he was long gone. But, still, you know, it's 20 horses, and if they decide, some of them decide to take hold more hold and pace isn't like they figure it's going to be, you know, they gotta ride hoping, you know, going a mile and a quarter, they're not going to ride like idiots and go out there 1,000 miles an hour if they can help it. They gotta save something for the end. So, you know, if it pace not be as fast as everybody thinks it is, and if they're coming by the stands in a big ball, you know, we'll be in trouble.
Biggest concern is ground saving from 20.
Yeah, because, you know, his two best races by far were where he was able to tuck in on the fence because he stays competitive that way. Yeah. Two races in Florida where he got hung out wide, he spit the bit out as soon as he turned down the backside. You know, most horses will do that. They know what they're up against. They don't like seeing fresh horses keep moving away from them when they're trying to move. You know, it's one thing if you're losing ground on a far turn. Most of the time the horses are stopping in front of you. So they see them backing up in front of them, and it gives them a, you know, makes them feel like going on. It's a different story in the first turn, you know. That's why it's so important.
You got a cool customer in Rajiv there, you know.
Yeah.
You got a good pilot.
Yeah. He's, you know, he's there's nothing, you know, there's nothing fragile about him. He really likes the horse. He seems to have a good little. He seems to have a rapport with him. Because, you know, he's not the nicest horse in the world in the post parade. So, but he deals with him. He deals with him great, and he, especially last time, he did a terrific job with him on Wednesday. So, just have to do the same thing.